coming up. The Phillies are out in front, 5-0. Seventh inning ready to roll, and stepping up is the shortstop, Willie Adames. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Breaking ball below the zone. That's ball one. Hit hard toward the right side. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
Everyone knows that this guy's numbers are not where he wants them to be so far this year, but you never know by that swing. He looked fluid and confident driving that pitch for a double. We'll see if that gets him going a bit.
Into the box now, Michael Brasso. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. A hit in two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Hit fairly well out towards straightaway center. Catch made in straightaway center as the runner tags from second. And he'll get into third here on the flyout, so he's 90 feet away here with one gone.
Number 33, Francisco.
And now in the box, Francisco Mejia. First pitch on the way. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. With runners in scoring position this season, Mejia is below the Mendoza line, the batting average under 200, unfortunately.
He'd be the first to tell you he's not happy with his batting average this season, but he can beat you in a variety of different ways, and he has to because he wouldn't be here otherwise.
Harper's got it. Here comes the runner from third. And the shutout will disappear on the sacrifice fly as they're finally on the board here in inning number seven. Next, it'll be Manuel Margot. Bases empty and two gone following the sacrifice fly. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. Takes this the other way to right, and that's in for his second hit of the afternoon.
Obvious pitch recognition right there. 0-0 changeups usually get guys out in front, but he was able to stay back, recognize it, and drive it for a base hit.
Michael Gigliotti will look for some two-out magic here as he'll pinch hit with two gone and a runner at first. From the belt, the pitch, as the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike.
We're moving right along into this one. This guy's continuing to pitch well, which is a little bit of a surprise because...
And we'll just leave it there as they make the play to end the inning. So a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. Bottom of the seventh now. Get up and stretch here in Philly. Philadelphia leads this one 5-1. Darwin's and Hernandez is on his way into the ballgame now as he'll be making his 50th appearance of the year. Now at the plate is Aaron Nola. He's been great on the mound, so we'll see if he can do something with the bat here as well. He's earned a chance to take this at bat.
Yeah, Matt, when a guy's throwing the ball as well as he has, it kind of forces the manager's hand to stay with him. He's been exciting to watch, and he's really had this crowd behind him the entire game.
Alec Bohm is up off the bench as he'll be asked to get something started in the home half of the seventh. First offering on its way. He enters here right at the 290 mark. Four home runs and an even 20 RBIs. Behind 0-2 now.
You can definitely tell with that foul off right there that he's picking up spin on this pitcher's off-speed stuff. Maybe expect a fastball on this next one.
And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone. Digging in will be Willie Castro. Flew out last time up.
throw.
He's set and the pitch. Hernandez has a good reputation for preventing the long ball. One swing can change the complexion of the ball game when you're coming in late, but he rarely lets that happen. Part of what makes him as effective as he is. The 1-0 gets him to chase a ball out of the zone for the first strike. Seventh inning here in a 5-1 ball game. A ball and two strikes now.
That's just too much velocity upstairs to get good wood on it. It's going to have to lower his sights.
Here comes the 1-2.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
Hit in the air down the right field line. He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in. Around second now, and this ball still hasn't been fielded. And he's in there at third with a one-out triple.
And that's the chance you take when you lay out for a ball like that. You make the play, and you're a hero in the highlight shows. You miss it, and you're picking yourself up and chasing after it.
In now, Joaquin Dias, and he's a bit tardy there on the first pitch fastball. It's nothing and one.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here, so we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
Fastball, and ooh, that ran in and drilled him.
And I'll tell you, this is the last guy in the lineup you want to put on base for free. He's probably feeling a little salty after getting drilled, and he's got speed to burn, so look for him to try and make something happen out there.
And that'll bring in the switch hitting Francisco Lindor, as he can't catch up on a fastball to letters, and it's strike one. Throw over to the bag, but the runner's back easily. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. Pitch swung on and missed. And they put the tag on him for the out, and he must be saying, "Are you trying to kill me?"
Obviously, they got a little over-aggressive there, but when you've got the lead like this, you can afford to do that a little more. We'll see if that lost run ends up being a factor at all.
Oh, and two, here it is. Swing and a miss at one in the dirt. Mejia gathers. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. Devin Williams will come on now, as he'll be appearing in his 45th game this year. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in Kevin Vizcaino, 0-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. First pitch of the AB now.
Hey, there's an old saying in baseball, you need to take a strike in this spot. Well, he got one there. Now he just needs to find a way to get on.
That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike. One and two now, as that one's fouled off. Into the windup and the pitch. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game. It's a bullpen game for them now, as we have a look at the starter's final line. And he'll be very happy with how the day went.
Yeah, Yeah, he looked really dialed in from start to finish. This is the kind of outing you hope for every time you go out there. So I think he'll feel pretty good about the effort he put forth in this one.
Yandy Diaz comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. And this is a fastball that's right on the black but ruled a ball. It's 2-0 now. Too tight with that one. 3-0. Austin Meadows waits on deck. Here it comes, the 3-0.
Three balls, one strike.
Takes this the other way to right, and a knock for him this time. He's 2-for-4 for the game.
Got to be a little frustrated on the offensive side. Yeah, everybody's getting knocks, and the batting averages are flowing right now, but nobody's come up with that big runner in scoring position, two-out knock kind of feel that really is going to break this game open.
Austin Meadows is at the plate as he watches ball one. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. On the ground is short. This could be two to second for one. On the first, it's a double play as their woes continue. The inning is over. Rays held in check here. They're down here 5-1. Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and that'll bring in a dangerous hitter indeed in the form of Bryce Harper.
And going back to that previous at bat when he hit the two-strike breaking ball for a home run, something tells me that this guy, when he gets behind in the count, sits on something off speed or the breaking ball.
With this one almost in the books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Yeah, you ain't kidding, Matty. Dan, what does this feel like when balls are just flying out of the yard?
D-Row, it's just one of those days when you're out there as a pitcher going, oh, I wish I was somewhere anywhere else but on that bump right now. This has the makings of being a long game.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. A bouncer to the left side, reined in. And the throw is wide as it pulls the first baseman off the bag.
I know that has to be frustrating from a pitcher's standpoint, but nice execution, nice hustle. Bottom line, nice hustle. Pitcher's still one good pitch away from getting a double play.
You know, D-Row, one of the things you want to do is make quality pitches as a pitcher, and there's not much you can do right there. You make a pretty good pitch, and the next thing you know, you have a leadoff single on an infield ground ball.
Giancarlo Stanton now, as he'll look at a breaking ball that misses for ball one. So far, 2-for-3 in this one. That evens it up, 1-1. Hard liner towards short. A leap here, but it ticks off his glove. There's one.
Hey, that's great teamwork, I guess. Not a pretty out, but helping your teammate out like that and then knowing he had time to go to second for the out is a pretty heads-up play. I got to think there's some good communication down there between the infielders as that play unfolded.
At the plate now, Rhys Hoskins. Fouled away. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. He looked like a caveman swinging a club on that one. It's 0-2 now.
Really tied him up on that one.
Yikes, he kind of looked clueless on that swing right there, Matt. If I'm pitching, I'm going right back to that same pitch.
Breaking ball, called third strike as that catches the zone for route number two. Digging in next, Javier Baez, who could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. First pitch of the AB on its way. Here's a drive out toward left center field. Stanton rounds the corner and is headed home. He will score as they push the lead to 5 now. The tag, and they'll get him at second. And with that, the side is retired. So it's one run on 2 hits, no errors, and no one left. We've played 8 full. Philadelphia is out in front here, 6-1. Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier. He's batting cleanup in this one, but we'll get us started here in the inning as they look to wake up the bats.
Yeah, not much to get excited about with just a single notch on the scoreboard, but you have to give credit to where it's deserved. The pitching on the other side has been really impressive.
First delivery to him. Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball.
Non-competitive pitch right there runs the count to 2-0, and he is ready to do some damage in the box.
And he gets this fastball over. It's 2-1. To first. Hoskins has it. And he'll step on first for the out. 3 unassisted. Next, it'll be Willie Adames. He came across to score after doubling in his last at-bat.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
Swing, and he rockets this one down the left field line. But that'll stay in the park as it's off the left field wall. And he is in at second base with a one-out double.
Well, he was definitely not looking off speed on that pitch. I'll tell you, he had to be sitting on a fastball on that one because it's coming in hot, and he still manages to get out front of that and yank it for 2 bases.
Stepping in now, Michael Brasso. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. And that one misses upstairs, 2-0.
He's going to have a talk with the umpire after this half inning, because if he's not going to get those calls, he's got to come a little bit more over the heart of the plate, and that usually means damage done.
3-0 to him now. From the belt, kicks and deals. And that misses ball four. So with one out, that'll at least set up the double play possibility here that could get them out of the inning.
The catcher, number 33.
Up next, Francisco Mejia. And these guys are making a little push here. You have to like the effort despite the odds.
Yeah, you really do, Matt. Look, they still have a significant hill to climb, but hey, they string a couple of hits together here, and all of a sudden this thing feels doable.
First pitch on its way. Hey.
Awesome execution right there. Great pitcher's pitch and an excellent job to get ahead in a tough spot.
Set up away with the changeup, but it's 1-1.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
A swing, and he pops him up on the infield, and the infield fly rule will be in effect here. Now it'll be Manuel Margot. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. 2 out here in the ninth. Looking to wiggle out of this. Here it is. Now the 1-0. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Throw on to first is in time to get him. And the Phillies have earned a sweep here in this brief two-game series as this ball game is over. 6-1, the final tally today. The Phillies win their 40th game in front of the home crowd this year. Aaron Nola earns a league-high 18th win. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.